Well, hello there. Welcome to another edition of Beviana's Chronicles. So there we were, driving along, minding our own business. And in the process of driving along, of course, we were reading a couple signs. And one of the times that we were driving through St. Elizabeth, we saw a sign that said Jamaica Zoo. And we were like, Jamaica Zoo? A zoo in St. Elizabeth? This is something we're going to have to check out. So we made it a point of duty to come back and find Jamaica Zoo. In the process of doing that, we sort of reflected on how we even came to have the concept of a zoo in the first place. Let's take a look in the book of Genesis. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and fowl that they may fly above the earth in the open firmament of heaven." And God created great whales and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let fowl multiply in the earth." And God said, "Let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beast of the earth after his kind." And it was so. And God made the beasts of the earth after his kind, and cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Good indeed. So I now invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy part one of two parts of our trip to Jamaica Zoo. Enjoy! Thank you.
your skin up to 4 to 12 times a year in order to get a roomier skin layer, as well as to discard off any form of parasites on the skin. So the skin, it carries all the detail that the snake has as well, both on the tummy and on the top. And even though lips look so small, she's that long. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so from lips, we'll move on to yellow, and we're gonna welcome her the same way that we did with lips. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna say, Burmese python. Yes. Hello. She's a very big girl. Mm-hmm. Ready? Mm-hmm. Yes, come right ahead.
Hi, hello.
Ready for the weight?
Wow.
Yes.
This is a heavy snake.
That's a lot of weight.
Hi, yellow. Hi.
You're not allowed to talk to me. Yes, I'm speaking here. Maybe you want to talk to me for me, but I'm speaking first. They can't hear me. You're louder than me. Thank you. Thank you. So he spends his time grooming his feathers. He can't afford you to mess it up. So if you go to touch, a big no-no. So he'll go on your hand, on your shoulder, or on your head. And he frequently talks with the others that are over on the other side now, so he's not trying to harm you. It just gets a bit loud sometimes. So come on.
Hi guys. Good morning. bird of Honduras. The females will lay up to 2 to 3 eggs, incubate them for 5 weeks, then they'll fledge in 90 days after. Whereas the blue and gold are the blue and yellow macaws. On the other hand, the female, she'll have the same amount of eggs. However, only one chick is dominant. So that chick will eat most of the food, and unfortunately, the rest are just left to perish.
Wow.
Yeah. So moving on from our macaws, and we're going over to the crows and crows. Heart? No? Okay. So she does this at times. Sometimes she's in a good mood where she comes down out of the goodness of her heart. But most times I have to bribe her with food. Our ground squirrel by the name of Sandy. So ground squirrels got their names as they prefer to live on the ground or in the ground rather than. So these are our yellow snakes or Jamaica boas. They can grow up to 6 feet in length. They can also be found in the Cockpit country as well as on Goat Island. So they live up to 24 years in the wild, however in captivity they will live up to 30 years. Now their boa constrictors, and what that means for them is that they will grab their prey, wrap around them and squeeze until they are lifeless, then they go right ahead and swallow their prey. Depending on how big the meal is, it will take up to 4 to 5 days for them to fully digest it. However, they won't need anything to eat for a week or two because of their very slow metabolism. Now inside you see some half jugs. Those are to store their water. They're very excellent swimmers, however they prefer to live in dry land or in trees. Yes. So from our reptiles, we go over to some very cute of the rodents family. However, the bigger type, known as the capybaras. So the female is called a doe, the male is called a buck, and their children are called kits. And the doe is capable of having up to 4 to 12 kits every litter each month. And an OMG fact about her is that she is able to become pregnant right after giving birth. So she'll give birth this morning, and in the evening she's pregnant once again. Yes, yes, yes. They don't waste time. So in the wild they live up to 1 to 2 years. However, in captivity they will live up to 8 to 12 years. Yes. And the rabbits are also known to eat their poop in order to redigest any nutrients that they didn't get on the first trip.
Okay.
Yes.
So they don't waste anything?
No.
Thank you.
me. She has an tendency where sometimes when she sees the basket, she knows that there's food inside, so she doesn't want to speak for me. So this is our Amazon parrot by the name of Miss Sharika. Yes, hello.
Hi, Sharika.
So she, I say Miss because she's all of 51 years old. She can live up to 75 years. So they're known very well for mimicking human speech. However, she can be sometime-ish, so we're gonna see if she's up for speaking to us today. Hello? Hello?
Hi.
No, no, I didn't bring you down here to eat my steak. I want you to talk for me. No, it's not eating time. It's talking time. Say hello. Hello.
Hi.
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 Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. No, it's not eating time. No, leave that. Say hello.
Hi.
You wanna laugh? Ready to laugh for me? Wanna laugh? Ready? Due to an oil gland located to their rear end that they will use their beaks to lather onto their feathers. Two is that they have internal air sacs that they will use to store air. Three is that their feathers are also able to trap air. And four is that they have hollowed bones, which makes them light. So you are able to feed our ducks. Okay, you feel like coming down today. Okay. Because their pond just got cleaned yesterday, and I guess because they were too bougie, they didn't come down for any feeding.
How has it been so far? Nice, don't it? Yes, man, these animals are really something else. And when you think about it, remember that man was given dominion over the animals. We were told to take control of them, so to speak. So there really should be no reason why we should not live in harmony with them. Would you take some of the chances we did withholding and touching some of these cute, cute creatures? We are going to be cutting it right here at the duck pond, and next week we're going to pick up and show you the rest of the zoo. So until next week, road is out there to do, road is going to be done by Bebiana's Chronicles. Stay tuned for part two next week. Bye.